Praise the Lord. Once again, I greetings to you in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. There are situations, there are times, you know, we feel very lazy in our life, you know. We just away from the works of God. We just be very lazy to pray for the people, very lazy to preach the word of God, and very lazy in our daily works. You know, laziness brings us sadness, and laziness brings us poverty. That's why, my brothers, today I wanted to speak about this lazy situation. You know, when you are lazy, you will not do anything quickly and anything with interest. This is what the word of God, what the word of God says. We will go ahead and we'll see. The laziness is very dangerous. It will steal our blessing, and we will become poor and poor when we have laziness in our life. Proverbs chapter 10 verses 4, it says, lazy hands make poverty, but diligent hands brings wealth. Then if you are lazy in your works, it will bring you poverty. But you diligently, if you seek the Lord and you work for God, and it will bring wealth. My dear brothers and sisters, many of the situations when we don't have any work, when we are having any, you know, leaves in our work, daily life, we always, you know, take leave and we just sleep. You know, sleeping is one of the lazy thing that we do in our life daily. We should not have laziness in our life. We have to glorify God. We have to give that glory, and we should, you know, support each other. We should love each other, and you know, we should be very conscious of the works of God. The laziness will bring you poverty. So that's why don't be lazy. Every time do some work. Every time pray. Every time preach. Don't sleep. Unless you get sleep. You know, some people will be very lazy every time. When they are lazy one day, the second day also will be lazy. The third day will be lazy. Fourth day will be lazy. And the 1 week completely they will be lazy. And they will not go to Sunday service. And next Sunday also they will not go, because they didn't go first Sunday. And second Sunday they will not go. The people, they will not go on third Sunday also. And fourth Sunday, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. And at last, they will think, oh, our pastor will may ask us. So, 1 year, yearly once. So, laziness, they will come. Yearly once, they will come to the churches. That is why laziness is very, very dangerous. It brings poverty. We don't have anything in our heart when we don't have anything in the life to eat or to do something. That's why don't be lazy every time. Quick and do the work of God diligently without having any laziness. So, one more word. Proverbs chapter 12 verses 24. Diligent hands will rule, but laziness ends in forced labor. Diligent hands rule, you know, but laziness ends in labor. So, if you are lazy, you will be poor and poor and poor. That's why don't be lazy. Quick, do fast. Do everything with a good heart. As I said earlier, last time, the few sermons. And also Proverbs chapter 19 verses 15, it says, laziness brings deep sleep, and it shifts it to the go hungry. And also laziness will give you hungry. Not only poverty, it will give you hungry. What the word of God says. So don't be lazy. Every time do some work and pray. Some people, they will sleep till 10 o'clock. So don't be lazy. Get up early in the morning. Seek the presence of God. Pray every time. And listen the word of God. Voice of God. Get up every time. Don't be lazy. If you want to sleep, you can just sleep after 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock. After doing your personal works. But most of the time, you must spend time with your God. You have to spend your personal time with your God, and you will see great things happening in your life. Proverbs chapter 20 verses 4, it says, sluggard don't flow in season. So the harvest time they will look for fine nutty. If you lazily sleep, if you have laziness in your heart and sleep, the day you will suffer with lack of food, lack of things in your life. You will be hungry. Every time you will go out and you will ask everybody and you should eat something else. So such a way it will happen. So that's why don't be lazy. Work hard. As the word of God says, don't be lazy. Work hard. Laziness gives you sleeping. Laziness gives you poverty. Laziness gives you lack in your life. So that is why don't be lazy. That is the word of God says. Proverbs chapter 6 verses 9 to 12. How long will you lie there, you sluggard? When will you get up from your sleep? When you will get up, you will think, oh, I will get up by 10 o'clock. Okay, I will get up by 8 o'clock. I will get up by 9 o'clock. But when you do it, when you keep on doing it, it will be like a habit for you. Every day get up early morning, it will be habit for you. If you get up by 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, it is also a habit for you. So that's why don't laziness, the sleepiness makes like habit. But you just go ahead and wake up, pray early morning, seek the presence of God, and let your lazy will not bring you poverty. Be activated, be energetic in the sight of God, pray every time, and be quick and ready to do something for the glory of God. When you do ready to do great things for the glory of God, God will bless you. That's why laziness is very dangerous. Don't be lazy. From today, become very lazy, please don't become lazy. Laziness means poverty. Laziness means sleeping. Laziness means lack of things in your life. That is why don't be lazy. Pray and read the word and get up early morning. And as you seek the presence of God in the day and night and early morning and soon as you want it, and activate in fast action. Be activate every time. Be quick in every time. Don't be lazy. Do God's work. Do something for God. You are doing for God. When you do something for God's work, that means you are doing for God. So don't be lazy. Do work of God. Get up and pray. May God bless you. All your laziness will go and you will be a good person. No poverty, no sleeping, no lacking. May God bless you with all the prosperity blessings in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Amen.